Hey guys, Adam here, hope you're well. In this video, how I set up, film and edit multicam sequences. Okay, let's start with kit. Two cameras, two lenses, either an 85 and a 35mm prime, or two 85mm depending on the situation or the location. The first 85mm is always on my main cam. The second B cam will either have the other 85 or the 35mm on it. Sometimes I want it a bit tighter, a long aisle, or I want to focus on the couple. Sometimes a wide shot works great when I want to reflect the scale or the grandeur of the scene. Judge it as you see fit. Always have the A cam on a monopod, a little mini tripod for the B cam, and there's links to all of this equipment in the description. And that's the setup, all ready to go. So for the ceremony, the B cam always goes at the back of the room, preferably central at the back of the aisle. But if that's going to block the bride's entrance, then just off to the left or the right will do, as long as it's not in the way. Sometimes you get a balcony or like a raised platform to work with, which is bonus. Set that up and leave it recording, and I will go and position myself at the front with the main camera on the monopod. 85mm lens on that, and then I'd start that recording as well. Obviously I'd have the audio set up by this point as well. I have done a separate video about how I get the audio, which I'll link in the description below, and it'll probably be floating around up here somewhere. Speeches are pretty similar. I'd have the B cam set up and focused on the bride and groom to get the reactions, or the bride's reaction for when the groom's doing his speech. Again, either the 35 or the 85mm lens, just depending on the day and the situation. I'd usually try and have the tripod about this sort of height, so it's eye level from a guest perspective. Again, main cam on the monopod, so I've got the freedom to move around a bit more, and I would focus that on the speakers, but I can always pull away and grab a reaction from one of the guests, so like a bridesmaid or one of the relatives, for example. I usually try and use the rule of thirds for the speeches as well, just so you're giving it that kind of direction.
Okay, so to edit these multicam clips, I've got set of speeches here from a wedding, angle set up on the bride and groom, angle focused on the speaker. On this wedding I used two 85mm primes. This was my static shot that I had on my little tripod. Guest perspective height, I just had this set up next to a table of guests, focused on the bride and groom, and I was on the monopod with the other camera on an 85 getting the speeches, and I'm free to sort of roam around and cut to guest perspectives a little bit as well. So I've got my two shots here, my two different angles, and I've got the audio file here as well that I recorded with the Sony TX650s. To create the multicam clip, I'm going to drag over all of these files in the browser, right click and go on new, click new multicam clip, click on that, and it'll ask me to give it a name, so I'm just going to call it speeches. Okay, that's going to sync up. 99% of the time the audio files will sync up automatically, but just to double check, what I always do, take this new multicam clip that we've created, drag it into the timeline. I've got a new project set up here, and if you double click on it, you can see all the files in here. So I've got the two video files and the audio, and they've spaced themselves out and they've synced up automatically. But if it doesn't, you can manually move these about, find where they need to be and manually set them up. You could, of course, there's another piece of software called Pluralize, which syncs things automatically, but I'm quite happy doing it like this. Now that I'm happy that it's all synced up and the audio is in line with the actual video, you can come back out of here and you've just got this big long multicam clip in the timeline. So the next thing you do is go up into View, Showing Viewer, Angles, and it'll open like this, and this is where you start to edit the multicam sequence. So obviously I've got all this black space here before the actual video footage starts, so I can trim the fat there. You can edit this like a normal video file, like a normal clip, but we've got this angle view up here which lets you see all the different angles that you've got. First thing to do is I want the audio to be coming from the audio file and not the cameras itself, so I just want to enable the audio for now, so I'll click on that, and then I'm going to click on my speeches audio. And that's my Sony TX650 file, and that's going to change the audio for the whole sequence. And then I'm going to enable the video angles, because I'm not concerned with audio now, that's sorted, so just enable the video angles. But basically I'm just going to hit the spacebar, hit play, let this sequence play through, obviously I've got my two angles running here. The one highlighted in blue is the one that's selected at the minute, but if I wanted to change and show the speaker, I just click on that relevant angle. All you need to do is watch it through. When the speaker says something emotional or funny and you want to get the bride and groom's reaction, you can cut away to their reaction and get them laughing. And then you click back here to cut back to this angle. And you can see down here in the timeline, it's actually making the cuts for you as you're going along. So every time I'm clicking between these two, it's making the cuts. I'll just skip to the groom's speech here, click the angle I want to play at that time, make the cut, and I'm just playing through the whole entire speeches, cutting between the angles as I go along, and it's generating my multicam video down here. And that's it, job done. You just play through the entire thing, cutting as you go. And of course you can make tweaks if you need to down here in the timeline as well, so you can move where it's made a cut between two angles. You can slide this along if the transition between the two angles isn't exactly where you want it. You can just slide that along, make it look a bit neater. And then once that's done, all you've got to do is color grade it if you need to, and export the finished video, and job done.
So that's how I make multicam edits for my wedding film. If you've got any questions, then leave me a comment below. I hope you found this video useful. See you in the next one.